Ashley, disappointing start for the Bears.
Yeah, really disappointing. First two games after high hopes of the winter, certainly the 3 months I've been here. We've done a lot of good preparation, but certainly not put that into practice in the matches. And, it's certainly hit the dressing room pretty hard, but all we can try and do is turn that around.
The club is, in a period of transition, not only off the field with yourself and Jim having just taken over, but also on it.
Yeah, myself and Jim are fully aware of the job that lays ahead for us. And I guess that's perhaps one of the reasons I've been brought in. Whether it's transition, it's possibly transformation. Probably some big changes lie ahead. A lot has been written and spoken about us having quite a senior group of players, an older group of players, and that's correct. And we've admitted that. And with very little then, and down to we've got a big group of sort of 19 to 21 year olds. So we have a gap there, certainly in our playing staff, and we need to address that gap. Clearly, again, we have a group of very experienced and high quality players. And myself and Jim are very hopeful that they can help us make that transition. But of course, results have got to improve.
There's been a lot of talk, of course, amongst the Bears fans, understandably, about possible recruitment. Recruitment's a pretty complicated business in cricket, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. I mean, if I try and explain it, there's a number of ways we look at recruitment. So there's the traditional way, external recruitment from other counties. Now, to explain that in a bit more depth, what happens every year, we receive lists of players who might be out of contract at the end of that coming year. Of course, there's always a little bit of word of mouth as well and rumour spread, whether that be through the media or other channels. And at the end of that year or during that year, we can approach those players and freely speak to them. But this isn't a football market. There's not an open transfer system in cricket where if you have a gap in your playing squad, you can just go and replace that. So, you'll often see football managers go and get six players straight away as soon as they're appointed. That just doesn't happen in cricket. The other aspect of that, of course, is availability. So which player is going to be available each year? Your high-quality players are generally going to be tied into long contracts. So that makes your recruitment, again, quite challenging. The other aspects, of course, are internal, and that's through your development systems, through your pathway. And traditionally, that's something we haven't done very well. And that isn't just over the last 10 years, that's over the last 30 years. And it's an area, certainly, we need to look at. We need to put a lot of resource into. There are some signs with the likes of Panay, Lamb, Sunny Singh, Liam Banks coming through that academy who are now on our staff, and a couple of those guys have played first-class cricket, but that's quite a long process. The other channels we've used before, are going out there and looking for players who are perhaps what I call just bubbling under or slightly broken, and we've done that in the past. So Barker, Wright, Clark, if you like, Rankin, Porterfield, are all guys we've brought in from the outside who've had very successful careers with the Bears, and that's another avenue we can look to address. The last avenue, of course, is your overseas players and perhaps sometimes the cold pack market, which is one we don't have any great desire to move into, but I feel we've recruited well on overseas front. Jeetan Patel remains our frontline overseas player, and we've recruited well for T20 this year with Colin de Grandhomme and Grant Elliott. But as you can tell from what I've just said, there is no quick fix to recruitment in cricket. It's a long process, and sometimes you have to be prepared to go back a little bit to come forward.
But there is some money in the budget for recruitment. It's just a question of getting the right players rather than just any players.
Absolutely. We've consistently invested well in cricket on and off the field, and the club will do that as we move forward. It is about bringing the right people to the club. So the worst thing I think we can possibly do is have a knee-jerk reaction and sign the wrong people for the wrong reasons. This has to be now a long-term project. There will be a certain amount of pain, and there already is for us. In the short term, we still need to try and win games of cricket. And we're going to be asking a lot from our current players, more than anything, a lot of fight. You know, we've got to play better cricket, but we've also got to fight now. We're in a scrap in this division, and we've got to work hard. And many of these guys have been through these battles a lot, and it's ultimately they're in position. It's down to them. You know, can they keep coming back? Can they keep going to that well and coming back for that fight? I hope they can. And if they do, and if we start to play better, then we should see some better results.
Well, I've seen how much they're hurting after this start of the season. Of course, in the immediate future, it's another tough one, isn't it? On Friday, Surrey at Edgbaston, looking for a reaction, of course.
Yeah, always looking for a reaction. And as much as anything, 11 guys on the field who are prepared to fight for the Bears. There's a lot of pride out there. And again, a lot of these players in this dressing room have done a lot for this club in the past, and we're asking them to go again. Surrey is a tough challenge. It was down at the Oval, but we just need to play some better cricket, and that is all round. We've not been able to put runs on the board, but at the same time, I think our bowlers will hold their hands up and said they've perhaps underperformed as well. So across the board, we need to be better. We need to see better results.
And the big decision for you and Jim and Ian is any changes to the team possibly for Friday?
Well, look, we'll look at everything. We're not playing well, and so we have to look at all our options. Someone like Ian Westwood will be playing in the second team this week. Hopefully he comes through that from a fitness point of view and a runs point of view. But everything is on the table at the moment, and we need to look at all our options going into Surrey next week.